Hello guys, my name is Tom, and actually in this video I will show you guys that how you can manipulate data. Actually this is the second video which will be about data manipulation in Power BI. So for that video I have created two hypothetical data sets for you guys. So I will be using this US Census 2005 data and US Census 2010 data. So I will, both of these data sets are in Excel. So I will just open one of the data sets and I will show you what kind of variables this data set is capturing. So actually each row in this data set is telling us about each state of USA and what's the and the variable which we have are about population, religion, and variables about demographics. An important thing to note here is that we have variable year, which is 2005 for all the observation, and we have a dummy variable which is 1 for all the observation. But in my second dataset, which is the US Census 2010 dataset, is exactly the same dataset, same in terms of variable. They have the same variables, but there is no dummy variable in 2010 dataset. And in this video I will show you guys that how you can append the data sets. So now we move towards Power BI, and then I will show you guys that how you can append these two data sets. So I will go back to Power BI, and now the first thing is that in order to append data set, first you need to pull those data sets into Power BI. So first I will go to get data, and as I told you guys that the data sets are in Excel format, so I will select the Excel format. And now first I will import US Census 2005 data. I will say open. So and now Power BI is connecting with that 2005 data set, and now Power BI is telling me that in that data set I have a sheet named as 2005. So I will tell Power BI yes, import this sheet into Power BI, and I will load it. Now Power BI is loading the data from Excel to Power BI. So as you can see that my data set is now uploaded into Power BI. All the variables which are appearing in the first row, all the observation, all the things that are appearing in the first row of Excel are considered as the variable name. That's why whenever you are importing data into Power BI, make sure that the first row in that data set is representing the variable names. If the first row is blank or not representing the variable name, then probably you will get errors when working in Power BI. So make sure whenever you import dataset that the first row of your dataset is actually representing the variable names. So I've imported the first dataset. The good thing about Power BI is that at a single time you can import as many dataset you want. So now I want to import another dataset into Power BI. So again I will go to get data. Again my file is in Excel format, and now this time I will select 2010 data, and I will ask Power BI to pull 2010 sheet from that data set. I will say load, and now Power BI will import 2010 data set for me. So now you can see that here I have two data set, 2005 and 2010. And in this video I will also show you guys that this blank window is actually the report window. If you can see, this is the report window, and there is a window below it is actually the data window. If I click it, it will take me towards the data window, and as you can see there we have this data set in front in our window. But if I select 2010, my data set will get changed. Now I'm seeing 2010 dataset, and there is a window related to relationships. So in this window you can see that what kind of relationship these two variables, two dataset have. Power BI is telling us that both of these dataset, 2005 and 2010, have one-to-one relationship. Why it's a one-to-one relationship? Because both state, these two variables are both common in each variable, in each data set, and each data set is uniquely unique at state level. And this 2005 dataset is also unique at state level. So that's why these two datasets have one-to-one relationship. I will talk about the relationships of datasets in my later video. If you want to browse your dataset, you can go to data view and you can browse your dataset easily. But I will go back to my report window, and the next step is that I want to append data set. So whenever you have to do any structural change to your data set, so you always will need to go to edit queries. So I will go to edit queries, and as I told you that I want to append those data sets. So I want 2010 data sets below 2005 data sets. So I will say edit queries. So these 2005 and 2010 are actually the original datasets that I just imported in front of you guys. So before creating a third file, which will be the master file of both 2005 and 10, what I will do, I will first make a duplicate of 2005 dataset. I've selected the 2005 dataset, and then there is an option duplicate. What it will do, it will create a third dataset, which will be same as the 2005 dataset. So I will say duplicate. So now you can see I have a duplicate of 2005 dataset. If I right click it, I can rename it. I will rename it by saying 2005. So 2005, 2010. You can name it anything that you like. So I have named it 2005 and 2010. But currently, if I go back to my year, I just have 2005 observations, and now I want to append 2010 dataset to in this third dataset that I have just created, named as 2005_2010. So in order to do that, what you will do, you have to select that data on which you want to append your 2010 dataset. So after that, if you see in the home window, there is an option append queries. So I will click it, and after that, Power BI is asking me that you want to append two datasets or you want to append three or more tables. So for this video, I want to append two datasets. So this option is fine. I opted two tables, but you can also opt this table. It will not change much. So after that, there is a down arrow button, and I will tell Power BI that which dataset I want to append with this 2005_2010. This 2005_2010 current data is actually representing only 2005, and I want to append 2010. So that's why I will select 2010, and then I will say OK. Now everything went well. I didn't get any error. But the important thing to note here is that I'm still in 2000, I'm back to 2005_2010 dataset. But in order to see that Power BI have appended my datasets or not, so as I've told you guys that this year variable is 2005 for 2005 dataset and will be 2010 for 2010 dataset. So suppose if I scroll down, as you can see here, as US have about 49-50 states. So after that, the second dataset gets started, and if you go keeps on going down, it's remained 2010. So it's mean that dataset got appended. And the important thing to note here is that the variables like marriage is common in both 2005 and 2010 dataset. So that's why the variables which are same spells exactly the same so the data under those variables will be represented under the same variable name. But the another thing to note here is that if you guys remember that I've told you guys the dummy variable is only present in 2005 dataset, and it's one for all 2005 observation. So you can see that the variable which was missing in 2010 dataset, for those observations which are coming from 2010 dataset, the dummy variable is considered as null. Null means that data is missing here. In the same way, if there is any data, if there is any variable which is in 2010 dataset but not in 2005, then for 2005 dataset observation, that variable will be considered as null. So in this way, you can append datasets very easily in Power BI. And not only that, you can append two datasets, you can even append more than two datasets in Power BI. But in the end, I will also show you guys one more thing. Suppose that if you want to create new variables within Power BI, how you can do that? So in order to do that, if you go to within a Power, within this query window where you're writing your new query and you're manipulating your data, you can go to add columns, and within add columns there is an option custom columns. So if you go to custom columns, so actually this very new column name, so I can name it new variable. So after that, I can do different, even I can do different mathematical operations over this variable. So suppose if I want to create it, suppose I want to add, if you double click it, it will add that variable into this formula window. And suppose if you want to add this variable with this variable, and suppose if you also want to divide it by 4. So I'm just making us some hypothetical variable, but you can do as many as mathematical operations over through this window. So if I say okay, so now as you can see that Power BI have created a new variable for me and also applied mathematical operations over it. So I will talk more about generating new variables in my later videos, and in the next video I will also talk about how you can merge the dataset. But now, but before going close this video, so now you have done all your operations on this data and you have manipulated data. So and in the end, in order to finish all the things that you have done, because Power BI keeps noticing all the changes that you have done over this dataset, it's always necessary that you go to Home tab and say close and apply all the changes. Then say close and apply. So Power BI have applied, it applying all the changes that I have just done in front of you guys. So now you can see that I have also have 2005 dataset, which is appended dataset, and even now if I select, if I go back to here, I also have the variable that I have just created for you guys. So, and the next thing to note here is that now the last thing that I will show is both the second variable like the population. So the Power BI is creating created a graph for me, the bar graph, but I want to see the population by year. So now if I select year, you can see that I have, now you can see that Power BI have created that so now you can see the Power BI have created that graph for the separate years for me. So thank you for watching the video.